the less,
the more you. Why is that? Does that make sense? Check this out.
The less you need, that means sacrifice more things, because you don't need it. You don't need to have so much so therefore you get to work more. You don't need to have so much luxury items, so now you get to go and save money and direct it to something else that you want. You don't need to go ahead and constantly have a person next to you that's showing you love all the time. You don't need that. So now you get to go ahead and explore yourself and maybe find the perfect person. You don't need to go ahead and have everybody praise you and tell you, you're doing a great job, you're doing a great job. So now you get to fail. And from failing, you get to go and pursue what you really want to do and do new things versus only doing things that you're good at. The less we need, the more we have, the more we receive. If we need so much stuff, then we're constantly juggling our life, trying to upkeep all of these things that we need. Then we have less time, less energy. We don't want to give up things because we need it so much. And as we all know, success in our goals requires sacrificing, trade-offs, however you want to call it, right? We have to go ahead and let go of this thing so we can get that thing, because we only have a certain amount of time every day. We have a certain amount of energy. We need to direct it to the things that we really, really want. And if a person really, really needs a lot of things, it's hard to let go. And so therefore, if they keep holding on to the old, they can't go ahead and get the new. So just remember that. The less that you need, the more you can receive in your life. You know, sounds really easy, right? Oh yeah, just need less. How do you do that? How do you actually need less? Especially when somebody feels like, man, they need a lot of things just to feel happy. They need a lot of things just to go ahead and feel okay. So how do you actually need less things? The more that you see yourself to be, the less you need. If I see myself as being a great person, I see myself as a person, I see my life, I see myself as being whole. I see myself as not, I don't need to be successful. I don't need to be good. I don't need to be this or that. I see myself as I'm a good person. I am alive. I'm grateful to be alive. I see myself in a good point of view. Then I don't need more things. I don't need to do more things. I don't need to prove more things in order to see myself differently. If I see myself as being more, then I would need less. If I see myself as being less, like I need to, I need to have more material things. So this way I can have a better point of view of myself, then I need more. If I feel that I need to have a lot of people around me to praise me, to kind of boost me up, to make me feel like I'm loved, because without that, I see myself as not being loved. I don't love myself. I don't look at myself in a loving way. I am not proud of myself. I am not okay with the things that I do. I'm not okay being the way that I am. If I do that, then I see myself as being less, and therefore I need more. Now, I can't give up all these people around me, because if I give them up, then I'll feel less about myself. So these people around me make me feel good. So now I have to hold on to that. And what happened if there's things in my life that requires me to let this go? What if there's things in my life that requires me to go ahead and travel where those people aren't there, move somewhere where those people aren't there, get connected to another circle where those people aren't there, or go another path that's not aligned to this group of people that make me feel good about myself? Then how am I able to pursue it? The people that try, they hold on to this, but they want that, so they hold on to this. But they are constantly contradicting each other. And so therefore, they're in this life trying to make this happen, and they keep thinking in their mind, man, you know, I miss these people, I wish I was there. And every opportunity, they try to go ahead and reconnect. Because to reconnect makes them feel better about themselves. But that's attention. That's time. All that time that they're thinking in their mind, all that energy that they're directing here, they can be focusing on their new life here, on what they really want. Just as long as they have to let go of the old, because they don't need this. And they only need it if they look at themselves as being less. If they don't look at themselves as being a good person, being full already. I am good and perfect just the way I am. I'm perfectly imperfect. I love that line, you know? It shows that things aren't supposed to be perfect. The idea of perfect is flawed. You know, there's no such thing. But yet, because we created this word called perfect, and then we create this facade around what that word means by media, you know, movies and characters and all this stuff, now everybody strives for it. We strive for this perfection idea. When in reality, all it does is make us feel less about ourselves because we aren't this perfect way of being. So when we drop that, then we see ourselves as being imperfectly perfect the way it is, the way we are now. And then when that happens, we don't need as much stuff, you know? We need less and less. I mean, this is why minimalist people are, there's more minimalist people. The idea, the culture of minimalists is becoming more popular. People are traveling more in like tiny homes and vans and just needing less, letting it go. There's more people traveling now. And yes, while there's a lot of changes in technology and online businesses are growing, at the same time, somebody has to still let go of everything. And we're in a time right now to where this is happening. And so if you find yourself holding on to things, you know, feeling like you need so much stuff in your life, I need my pets and all this, I need my parents really close. You can love people, you know. It doesn't mean when you don't need them, when you let them go, it doesn't mean that you don't love them. But sometimes when you are pursuing something in your life and you have a contradiction, you can't hold on to this thing and also get this thing at the same time. You have to let one of them go. And when that happens, then being in a state of being where you need less things, that's the way to be. So this way you can receive more, the things that you really want. We only hold on to things, not because we really, really want it, but just because it makes us feel better about ourselves. We learn to go ahead and feel good about ourselves without those things that we hold on to. And that's how we receive more. The less you need, the more you get. So, thanks for watching.